Guy Johnson of Green Bay has smoked for most of his life.
I've always loved it. I started when I was about 8 or 9 years old, and I never really stopped for 56 years.
He switched to electronic cigarettes in September.
It's healthier. It hasn't been proven to be bad for you yet, that I know of.
Respiratory specialist Dr. Richard Potts points out e-cigarettes still contain nicotine. He says their long-term impact isn't known.
We don't know too much about e-cigarettes. They've just come on the market in the last 5 years or so.
Allison Bernstein of Green Bay has been using the product for about a year.
They call it vaping instead of smoking because you're not blowing out any smoke, it's just vapor.
She also sells e-cigarette products.
Bernstein says this store on Green Bay's east side opened in June, and since that time they have seen more than 1,000 customers.
But right now, Wisconsin law isn't clear on where e-cigarettes can be used. The state banned smoking in workplaces in 2010 before vaping was popular. The law doesn't clarify if vaping is banned. Republican State Senator Glenn Grothman of West Bend introduced a bill earlier this month that would ensure it isn't.
Well, we want to step in ahead of somebody in Wisconsin doing what New York City has already done.
Dr. Potts has another view. He says even though vaping emits small amounts of chemicals, it's still harming air quality.
Exempting them from the smoking regulations is actually a backward step for Wisconsin.
The bill is currently being worked on by a Senate committee.